Hello there. It seems you found yourself in the city of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and you have no idea what there is to do, see, eat, drink, or learn. You're in luck because I have some real dank recommendations on hand here. Some of these wonderful establishments or destinations did not make the cut for a variety of reasons. Mostly, I ran out of time and money to hit all the best stops with my camera. Honorable mentions will be written in the description along with a full list of everything featured. Full bias disclosure. I'm vegan, I work in the beer industry, and I live in South Philly. This will probably reflect that. But, you know, everything's subjective, everything's relative, and life is meaningless, so let's move on. First, a quick overview. Old Billy Penn himself founded this beautiful place, tucked between the Schuylkill and Delaware Rivers. It was the first capital of the United States. Through the American Revolution, and with the Founding Fathers, paved the way to the Declaration of Independence and the signing of the Constitution. History is still abound here on the streets of Old City. Common activities that people might recommend to you: Eastern State Penitentiary, the Philadelphia Zoo, the Mutter Museum, the Reading Terminal Market. All great places, yet Wawa included, I assume you already hit these stops. But you're still tired and you're still hungry, so let's look at the breakfast and coffee options here in the city. Federal Donuts. They make excellent donuts along with fried chicken. Fancy donuts are ready to go and tasty, but the hot and fresh selection is worth the wait. Also, some fantastic coffee is here, locally roasted by Elixir. Philly-style bagels. Fresh bagels boiled in beer. Quick serve and nice variety of spreads. Cool neighborhood. Grindcore House, a vegan cafe with tasty bagels, sandwiches, baked goods, and counterculture coffee. Greenstreet Cafe. The best house coffee for a very affordable price. Not too much seating or space, but a few chairs outside if you can grab them. Reanimator. Best pour-over coffee I've ever had. To my memory of that particular origin roast, it smelled of blueberries and almonds. Very comfortable seating. Let's move on to some food options here. If you've got a gluten allergy or sensitivity, you should try visiting Taffets Bakery in the heart of the Italian market. Very friendly service and very delicious baked goods. But if you want the best pretzel in town, go just about a block away to Center City Pretzel. It's the highest quality pretzel I've found in the city, leaving Annie Ann's, Philly Pretzel Factory, and Wawa in the dust. It's open from 12 a.m. to 12 p.m. noon. Francoluigi's, the best classic Italian pizza in the city, hands down. Not cheap, but not ridiculously expensive either. Some seating, with wine, beer, and soda pop available. The wine itself is BYOB. Antonio's, great cold hoagies, traditionally with broccoli rabe on a seeded roll. And plenty of great hot hoagies as well. We've got banh mi's in the city. Nam San is my favorite stop on Washington Street. The rolls always seem fresh, and the sandwich only costs $4.50. For authentic Mexican cuisine in South Philly, Los Gallos is my favorite stop. The place is comfortable, colorful, and tasty as all hell. Frangelli's, an old-school bakery with a unique claim to fame, the Frannoli, basically just a fresh donut with cannoli filling. Lots of other good baked goods. Stargazy. The owner of this wonderful gem on Passyunk is originally from England, and his meat and veggie pies taste like some serious home cooking that we miss out here in the States. Definitely order some potato mash with parsley liquor as well. Kaffa Crossing, some real good Ethiopian food for fair price in West Philadelphia. Also in the neighborhood, Honest Tom's, offering tacos and burritos with breakfast options and breakfast hours. Good variety of hot sauces, bottles floating around. Beer bars. American Sardine Bar. Comfortable outdoor seating and cozy indoor as well. Almost always a reliably good beer menu, and the food is just as good, I'd say. Tired Hands. Likely the most creative and sought-after beer in the Philadelphia region. About 35 minutes outside the city for both the Fermenteria, featured here, as well as the beer cafe right down the street. They specialize in hop-forward beers, fresh bread, and a decent menu with culinary inspiration. Four-pack can releases usually on Wednesdays, but the wait can be 30 to 90 minutes with no guarantee of enough beer to go around. Ray's Happy Birthday Bar. If you're just looking for a dive bar with $4 citywide specials, which is just a shot of Jim Beam and a can of Yuengling Premium, you're in luck. Smoking is tolerated here. Friday night karaoke makes this place a great little hole in the wall. Plus, it's open every day at 7 a.m., except Sunday. Monk's. This is the most well-known beer bar in the city for a good reason. The Belgian tap and bottle list alongside full pub menu is something to drool over for sure. I would definitely advise visiting Monk's on a weekday and during the day. Seating fills up quick, and it can be a pretty noisy place. There are some entertainment options I'd like to point out as well. Union Transfer. To me, this is the best venue, by far, for live music. The lineup of shows is always reliably strong, there's a decent selection of beer and cocktails at the bar, and for fair prices. Tickets are most often less than $25, and the building itself is a beautiful old railway baggage company, which at other points in time also served as a farmer's market and a spaghetti factory. Boot and Saddle, a lesser-known little music club on South Broad Street. Great for discovering small artists, and tickets are always cheap. Finally, there are some decent outdoor adventure options here in the region. Fairmount Park is most well-known, but just northwest of that is the even more hilly, rocky, secluded park known as Wissahickon Valley Park. There's a great network of trails for biking and hiking. If you're willing to travel a bit further, there are some very impressive trails and peaks along the Appalachian Ridge, about an hour away. Pinnacle Peak is just one of many. A few brief words about the present-day culture. Despite PA now being a red-leaning state, Philadelphia has been quite liberal for many decades. The seemingly progressive environment today, though, is the same city that is known for controversy and racial anxiety under the Rizzo administration. For example, in the 1980s, we were led to national attention over such acts including the dropping of military-grade C4 explosives by the Philadelphia Police Department over a violent eviction standoff with Black Liberation Group MOVE. 65 West Philadelphia row homes were destroyed and the fire department was instructed to let it burn. This is still evident on the blocks of West Philadelphia on Osage Avenue. More recently, there are protests surrounding the corruption and controversy of the Democratic National Convention, which was held here prior to a historic upset in favor of President-elect Donald J. Trump. After the election, even more protests erupted once results came in. In 2015, the World Meeting of Families was held here. With special guest Pope Francis in town, the streets of Center City were pretty much entirely shut down. Also in 2015, the New York Times rated Philadelphia third most impressive city to visit, following Milan, Italy, and Cuba. The United Nations declared Philly the nation's first World Heritage City, a testament to its culture and diversity. Anyway, thanks for watching. That's all I got for now, and I hope this helps you find something of interest or learn something new. Cheers.